CMUEagles.com with Central Methodist head football coach Jody Ford as the team prepares for its Week 6 opponent, Culver Stockton in Canton, Missouri, on Saturday, October 11th. Coach, your team was able to pull out a one-point victory over Culver Stockton in last season's wire-to-wire game. Just talk a little bit about that game, what you remember from it.
I just remember it being a physical game, a back-and-forth game. I thought both teams played extremely hard. It was a tough battle all the way through, and that's kind of what you expect when you play Culver Stockton. I mean, through the years, they've always been a hard-hitting team and a very physical team, and last year was no different. It was a tough run, but last year's last year, and it'll be the same way again this year. And we certainly got our work cut out for us and the challenge ahead with them.
In last season's contest, Culver Stockton rushed 47 times for 349 yards. 21 of those carries, 132 of those rushing yards, and two touchdowns went to Desmond Phillips. He's back again for the Wildcats this year as their leading rusher this season, averaging a little over 111 yards per game, six touchdowns for the season, a 6.9 average. What have you seen on film, and what makes him such a great running back?
Desmond's just a beast of a running back. I mean, he does a great job running behind his pads. He gets his pads down. He has very good feet. And I think the most impressive thing to me is his vision. I mean, he really finds the small creases, and he's a very patient runner. And then when it's open, he does a great job of finding the crease and hits it. And he does an excellent job at running back. And is a very tough, hard-nosed kid. And exactly what you want representing your program and your conference. He's done a great job this year. We have our work cut out for us with him, and definitely got to hit him because he brings it and does a great job running the football.
When you look at the Wildcats on the defensive side of the ball, they're led by defensive end David Marcinko, who's second on the team in tackles of 25, leads the team with 7.5 tackles for loss and 4.5 sacks. What does he bring in the defensive end position that your offense and Coach Brady has to focus on during this week of practice?
David is just a great football player. I mean, we tried to recruit him here too, and he's been a monster for them through the years, and he's been no different this year. I mean, to me, he's a first team all conference defensive end. I feel like he's that good, and he just flat out is a good football player. Very physical, very tough, plays smart, uses hands well, and has a great motor, and there's no weaknesses in David Marcinko. He's just a great player, and we got our work cut out for us with him.
Culver Stockton coming off a 45-0 loss to Grayson. When you look at the box score, Graceland didn't necessarily put up a lot of team stats, but they were able to generate 4 turnovers. Now, obviously, you know the bad side end of the turnover stick last year, but when you see that Grayson was able to generate 4 turnovers, how do you think that goes into your preparation and what you tell your defensive guys?
Well, I'm sure that's something that kind of happens. You never know how the game's going to go. I mean, we work on turnovers every week and hope to get our share, and we were fortunate to get 2 last week and almost had a third one. But turnovers, sometimes it's in part due to the work you put in practice, and sometimes you're just lucky, and hopefully we get a combination of both as we go forward.
Your team coming off an emotional 6-point victory over then 24th-ranked Mid-American Nazarene last Saturday. I know the team was extremely fired up and happy to get that win, but how do you get your team to refocus coming into this week's game?
Well, I think you get what you deserve, and if they choose to go about it the wrong way, we'll be in trouble. If they go about it the right way, we give ourselves an opportunity and a chance, and that's what we've really tried to preach with them. There's no time to be excited. I mean, Culver doesn't care, and neither do we. We got to put what happened last week behind us and go forward. There'll be plenty of time for reflection after the season's over, but right now we're knee-deep in the season, going through the middle of it. It's very physical, and Culver, I mean, they have a great team and a very physical team, and we got to be ready to go or else we'll get knocked off.